Please welcome back to the stage CEO of Grupo Semana, Maria López, and our esteemed panel.
Good evening.
Once again, I'm in this scenario
with one of the subjects that are very important for me, that has a big relevance for when we're talking about the future for the country. The creative economies are, without any doubt, a strong foundation of development for a country like Colombia. Colombia is a country that is absolutely diverse. We are the second country with more diversity. Just talking about the jungle in the Pacific Colombia, we are one of the first in diversity. Also, we are pluri-ethnic and pluri-cultural country. We have the wonder and the virtue of being a country that has 93 indigenous languages. This is really important when we're talking about the development of the creative economy and the process that is going on here in our country. I have the big pleasure of a woman that I admire, and is Donna Karan.
It is a pleasure for us to have you.
So we're talking about what is this panel about. You are going to be so excited as me to have an extraordinary woman is here.
What you are doing in Colombia and what you're cooking with many artisans and many craftsmanships, it's going to be very exciting for them. Also, we have in this panel Ana Maria Fries. Ana Maria is la directora artesana.
She's the director of Artesanías de Colombia. She's also with us in a second term of to continue with the legacy. And also Mónica Contreras, the CEO of PepsiCo, a woman, extraordinary woman that I admire deeply. And she's going to tell us what's happening in all of this subject and what Pepsi is in these creative and cultural subjects. Donna,
and I'm going to switch back to English, and excuse me for the back and forth. It's sometimes easier to convey the messages in our native tongue. Welcome to Colombia.
Thank you. Colombia
is a biodiverse country. It's a country full of multicultural heritage. And we're divided in many regions, in many zones, and this is truly a jewel for the world. Having you in Colombia is a true pleasure, and I would like to you to speak to us about urban Zen. Many people know about Donna Karan. They know about your enormous success in the fashion industry. But they don't know in Colombia what urban Zen is and why you're here in Colombia.
No, thank you for having me. This is truly remarkable. Thinking back to when Colombia, I was first exposed to Colombia. And when I had a store called at Donna Karan, I represented a group of Colombian artists, which I had just found out recently. I said, how fantastic these products are, it's incredible. But what I did was, I had a vision many, many years ago that I felt that it was not just designing and creating what you're wearing on your outside, mm-hmm. but more importantly, what's on your inside. Mm-hmm. So I've been a yogi for many, many years,
really?
Since I was 16 years old. And it was a little bit advanced in the yoga world. But I realized there's so much that our heart and soul say. And I found myself completely in awe of cultures around the world. I had been to Bali, and Bali sort of blew my mind. And I did a lot of work in Bali. And I realized how important artisan work is. the soul of an artisan. And it's very difficult as a designer, for if any of you are designers out here, it's all about what's new, what's new, what's new, what's new. And yet I love to design, and I love to design fashion and shoes and bags and furniture. Could you all hear me? Is it okay? Okay. But I wanted to dress and address. And it was a vision, which I think a lot of people here would understand, that it was like a scope of light that came through me about 20 years ago. And I had seen a place in a space where people come together who want to create change in the world. That you would live there, you would be cared for there, you would create a community there, and this community can create an energy from their cultures, the preservation of their cultures, their health care, and their education. So for me, urban Zen typifies where do we find the calm in the chaos of the world we live in today. It is about dressing and addressing the issues at hand. And I am so honored to be here in Colombia, which has been such an inspiration for exactly what Urban Zen stands for, that I am looking forward to really seeing Colombia and all the wonderments of it. Yes, it is.
Okay. This is your first visit in Colombia, and I know it's the start of a trip also. You're going to different places, and we hope that Colombia will have you very soon and with many projects. And for that, I would love to go to Ana María Fríez,
sure,
which is the director of Artesanías de Colombia. Ana María, háblenos un poco.
Tell us a little bit about the work of Artesanías de Colombia with the artisans of this language that is crafted in the bags in each region. Why is so important?
Thank you, Maria.
Donna, I'm sorry, I'm going to speak in my language. Artesanías de Colombia stimulates programs, and it's a program of development, inclusive development strategy, was creating different kind of incomes for the artisans of the country. For one side, we're trying to protect and preserve the culture, understanding that this is a material and immaterial patrimony, is a memory. The handicrafts and the artisans are the seed of the creativity in our country, is the DNA of our country that is in our artisans' works. What they do, and the people that do that, they just find the knowledge in their territory, in that region. They are expressing with the natural fibers of each region. And all of this production has a narrative that goes from one generation to another generation. So it's important to be clear that we are protecting the memory, the patrimony, and the culture. It's also clear for us that it's really important to strengthen with programs of development to our artisans. What we do is we have 33 laboratories of innovation and design. This is the umbrella of attention that is training in a comprehensive way the whole area. Per year, we have more than 10,000, 11,000, and sometimes 15,000 artisans according with our capabilities and our budget. Also, we do some management to launch, to gather more resources. We are trying to find different kind of connections and international level because we can, this is a cooperative work. It's important to know that is in this strategy of training, what we want is to empower our artisans so they can be micro entrepreneurs. We can strengthen the most important aspect in the chain. We're doing also a really strong work with the creative industry
in our country. We're working with architects, with designers, with fashion designers, with jeweler crafters. We see that we have an important growth in the artisan part and also the creativity industry. This is some kind of equation of equation plus equation is like a square. Creativity is an explosion of creativity because we can see more benefits. We can guarantee the preservation of the old techniques and the crafts, and also we have a productivity. Something that we want to have is to guarantee the sustainability along the time and to get more commercial opportunities so we can guarantee their incomes, because here in Colombia we have dozens of families that live out of this. Can we talk about some numbers of the economical contribution of this industry in the Colombian economy? I want to talk about what's happening with the fairs. In the fairs that we stimulate from our institution, they are creating a very important income for the artisans. It's about 60%, 70% of the income according with the dimension and the term of that fair. You can say with all the strategy that we are carrying out, we can give back the 26,000 millions of Colombian pesos. This is the beginning of a commercial relationship. This is the picture, the first picture that we have of the participation in the fairs. The numbers that were shared from Colombia, this is our main partner in terms of the promotion of our handcrafts works in the international to get some buyers, international buyers. In the fairs, we can close business for $1 million around that number, but the projection is to $3.5 million of US dollars. So we think that it's really important. Each day we're trying to strengthen the area in articulation with different kind of industries. Mónica, let's talk about the private sector. It's really important to strengthen the community work and reactivate the local economy so we can have a local process that are going to stay in the region so they can empower, identify this region. Why a company like yours is working in these subjects? Which one is your products of conservation in the communities? Thank you, Maria. Thanks to Concordia to open this panel that has a lot of sense. We are as a company. As a company, in fact, our vision is try to work with a purpose and to gain with a purpose. That's why we have an important contribution with our communities that we're working in. It's part of our DNA. We can see it all the business of potato cultivations and crops. We are an agro-industrial company. We cannot forget this. And that's why with this strategy, we believe that the indigenous community in truth represents for us part of what is the DNA of our country. The last year, because we wanted to keep growing with these communities, we introduced a new brand that is Natu. Basically, this was by December of last year. We invited to the Wayuu communities and also the pastors community. It is Aguilar that you are going to know in the next panel. She's been working with us. And through this brand, what we do is try to show to the rest of the country, the international country, which means the human interworld. You can find it in all the Natu pictures, all the signs from the Wayuu community and the pastors community. And through this, what we're doing is to creating and generating capabilities. We are involved, we are engaged with all the change production so we can transform over artisans and the orange. Now that we're talking about the orange economy, when the private company is providing capabilities in financial terms, in management terms, how they can manage their own business, how they can create a company through our brands. And right now we are really happy because in this new agreement that we did,
which has been a very important associate everything that we're starting now along with Donna, it's basically looking for the master, which is they're the ones bringing Donna as well as PepsiCo. We're going to place the same design of human tissue in these international communities. Nato is a brand that was born in Colombia. It's from Colombia to the rest of the world. We're really proud of this brand, and now we are absolutely proud of having Donna as this international sponsor of this public-private alliance in order to take the image of our craft workers, providing them with the necessary capabilities so that they continue working along with that purpose in this market. Thank you very much, Monica. And this is the main point of this conversation now. This is a panel that has two perspectives, or two parts. We are the first part, and now we're going to cover the second. But what is... we're focusing on looking for the masters. That's the big project that is bringing Donna to Colombia, and which really wants to work along with the communities of Colombia in order to dignify and in order to bring that ancestry and the great cosmovision of each region to the international market.
How do we look for these craftsmanships? How do we look for these masters in each region? How does your process start?
You know, it's very, very difficult for me because I know there's a huge amount of expectation. Because it goes, oh, Donna Karan, DKY, you know, we want all this merchandise. And that's not what we're looking for. Mm-hmm. We're looking to take their knowledge, appreciate their knowledge, and take it to the next dimension. Okay. Now, that's not something that happens overnight. You know, there's one thing to come in and purchase product from the artisans, and you see it everywhere in the world. And as I travel the world, I see a similarity now from one country to another. I'm not sure that's what belonged in that country. Uh-huh. You know, I just came back from Rwanda, and what I saw in Rwanda and the baskets that I saw in Rwanda, and then I see the baskets here, and I go, okay, what can we do with baskets? Mm-hmm. To make them unique and individual, to take it to the next dimension. We know the soul is in the weaving of the baskets.
Right.
And it's the same with the fabrics. Mm-hmm. How do we take fabric to the next dimension? I don't want to lose the soul of what this country stands for.
Right.
But it needs its own independence and point of view, and yes, as a designer, I hope to open the mind to the possibility of working with artists and designers which have all different points of view, absolutely, as your artisans do. For instance, this is a necklace, and I use this as an experiment.
Where is
these
that?
These are prayer beads from Ethiopia. Uh-huh. The necklace itself was made in Haiti.
Wow.
So it's a whole conglomeration of working with artists. Now, this is not your everyday. It's something that will last, as I'm looking at your earrings right now, which are absolutely divine.
Paola Mendoza,
you know,
jewelry.
And they'll last forever.
Founder of Looking for the Masters, I'm looking for you right now.
And I know Carlos right here is going with us. And this bag was a similar situation where you would see a pattern that was definedely from Africa. Uh-huh. Again, whoops, excuse me. Taken to Haiti, where I started a school there, uh-huh, for craftsmen to learn different ways of working, as I've done with the shoes that I'm wearing now. You know, they're not the shoe that you would see, oh, I've seen the shoe before.
Right.
It's how do you take it to another dimension? So with the shoe, which is really interesting, I spoke to Kenneth Cole, mm-hmm, who does soles. So I said, I want your sole, because I think your shoes are so comfortable. And the soles in Haiti were terrible. Uh-huh. But I love the uppers. So I said, if I take your upper and I put it with this sole, it's great. Now, I'd love to take his soles and bring them here to do it with your handicraft and your artistry. So it's sort of like connecting the dots, uh-huh, you know, and working with the best of the best and learning respecting your culture, mm-hmm, your artisans, And I must say, before we forget, is I must thank Carmen Passett.
Absolutely.
Because I know she'll be speaking with you shortly.
She will.
Who has really brought me to this continent. You know, it started in Guatemala. Mm-hmm. Then it went to, it started in Costa Rica. Then it went to Guatemala. And I said, I am dying to go to Colombia. I mean, this has been a dream of mine.
I love that you say that.
Because there is a spirit here in Colombia that I just kind of feel like I don't have enough time. And of course, everyone's saying, well, don't worry, you'll come back. But there's so much artistry, and there's so much creativity, and there's so much soul that truly started here. But in the world we live in today, and we know it's about this phone, and it's about tech, and all of that, and the word sustainability is a word that we keep on talking about. What is sustainability? What is something that's going to be carried on? How do we take what we've had for so many years, give it the next dimension and the next dimension? Because we're living in a world that we're all aware of everything that's happening all over the world. So what I say to designers, and that for me is the most important thing, is you've got to find your soul into your design. Mm-hmm. It can't be a knockoff. It can't be looking like somebody else. Everybody wants to be a designer. Everybody wants to be a model, you know. But I think what makes the true artisan, the true model, is the one that has something that perhaps is something from the past that is developed now, and being aware of the future, mm-hmm. and being able to have its flexibility. And I've seen this in so many countries that I've visited, you know, and yes, what Colombia stands for is brilliant and amazing. And it's pretty hard for me as a designer to say, how can I make that better? How can I take it to the next dimension? And that's what's important today. And it might not come from me, but what I hope it comes from is the younger people of tomorrow, the students. And if I could do anything, it's to explore the endless possibilities. But at the same time, what I want for Colombia, yes, is to continue its heritage, and which artistry is so, so important. But how do we take it to the future without it being felt like I've seen this, because our eyes are so exposed to so much today. Mm-hmm. So it's a challenge that we face, and it's a very exciting challenge as a creative person, because when you're an artist, you're always looking for another dimension.
Absolutely.
With the wisdom that is perceived in the past. So I'm hoping, and I know, you know, something's going to say, and people say to me, how do you do it? I don't really think about it. It's something that's sent to you, and when you work with your hands, as I do, you know, I drape it, I create it, you know, I take a human body and I play with fabric, and it's not done flat. It's done with understanding the human being. It's understanding how something is woven, how something is felt, how something is artisanally designed. And I think what I would love to happen here is that you don't have to be in the world. Your world is a beautiful world. Mm-hmm. To take that world to another element is magnificent. I mean,
absolutely.
Look how many wonderful people you have here. You know, but everybody's looking, oh, I want to show in Paris, or I want to show in Italy. I got the whole thing. You know, I was one of them, so I know. I don't want to show there. I don't want to show in Paris. I don't want to show in Italy. I don't want to show in the United States. I want to be able to really offer, you know, my ability to work with artisans, to work with designers, to be able to bring the awareness of what this amazing country has. But not only that, it's what you can do that possibly hasn't been done yet. So that's where the past and the present and the future come together to create Urban Zen.
Oh, that's fantastic. A round of applause for Donna Karan. Thank you. So I'm going to invite the rest of our panel, but before doing that, I want to ask you a quick final question with a quick response. And it's a deep question, but a quick response. What is your legacy? Is this your legacy? Is this what you want to leave in the world, this change of consciousness?
My legacy is love. If I had one dream, and I had this many, many years ago, is to put down the guns, to be able to realize that we're all connected as one, that we have a planet here, and connect the dots is what I call it, is to be able to touch you, touch me, touch you, and at 1 o'clock every single day, there will be a sound of your country being blown. And you have to stop for 1 minute, close your eyes, take a breath. It's all you have to do, and touch another person, and touch another person, and touch another person, and touch another person, and create a oneness in this world.
That's amazing, thank you. Mónica, tu legado.
Mónica, what's your legacy? In truth, I believe that the most important legacy as a company that we can leave is generating communities in Colombia that are sustainable. This is our work. That's something that we're called to have a purpose in our work and to transform the indigenous community with you and the pastors community that we just run this project, the sustainable communities, the capabilities of the first level, and a company that, like us, are providing them. That's our legacy. That is a really hard question. The legacy is the strength of the artisan area in our country, the recognition of a society and the world, the value of the handcrafters and what they build, the things that they do with their very hands is the memory of our country, a source of pride to use and to live there, to wear it, to have this identity through expressing that identity through the art work that they do, the elaboration of this art for the artisans to guarantee their incomes, to dignify the life, to feed and educate their kids, to protect the tradition and the culture so they can transform this into economical, social, cultural development in Colombia. Please, a big round of applause. I'm going to bring the mother of this subject, which is Cecilia Duque, which is going to replace me as a moderator. And she will have in the panel Alejandro Calderon, Iris Aguilar, and Carmen Brusquet. Thank you very much.